time to epileptiform activity and EEG background recovery are independent predictors after cardiac arrest. Via clinical neurophysiology. S13882457.gif. Publication date, available online June 9, 2018. Source: Clinical Neurophysiology. Authors: E. Westhall, I. Rosén, M. Rundgren, J. Bro-Jeppesen, Jake Kjaergaard, C. Hassager, H. Lindehammar, J. Horn, S. Ullén, N. Nielsen, H. Friberg, T. Cronberg. Objective: Investigate the temporal development of EEG and prognosis.MethodsProspective observational substudy of the target temperature management trial. 6 sites performed simplified continuous EEG monitoring, cEEG, on comatose patients after cardiac arrest, blinded to treating physicians. We determined time points of recovery of a normal voltage continuous background activity and the appearance of an epileptiform EEG, defined as abundant epileptiform discharges, periodic, rhythmic discharges or electrographic seizure activity. Results: 134 patients were included, 65 had a good outcome. Early recovery of continuous background activity, within 24 hours, occurred in 72 patients and predicted good outcome since 55.76% had good outcome, increasing the odds for a good outcome 7 times compared to a late background recovery. Early appearance of an epileptiform EEG occurred in 38 patients and 34.89% had a poor outcome, increasing the odds for a poor outcome 6 times compared to a late debut. The time to background recovery and the time to epileptiform activity were highly associated with outcome and levels of neuron-specific enolase. Multiple regression analysis showed that both variables were independent predictors. Conclusions: time to epileptiform activity and background recovery are independent prognostic indicators. Significance: patients with early background recovery combined with late appearance of epileptiform activity may have a good outcome. Add-tags: currently, Physiology, Medicine by Alexandros G. Sfakianakis,